As autumn comes, the animal's biology changes. Vitally important processes take place. Mating begins in the second decade of September and lasts till the end of the first half of October. By the time mating begins, bucks have an increased volume of sexual hormones accumulated in their blood from the front lobe of hypophysis. Fawns get fully rid of hair and skin. In the middle of September, one can observe bucks scraping out the remains of hair from their horns against young fir trees, which results in horns getting the tint of the fir bark. In the meantime, hinds tidy their hair near old fir trees, which exude soft resin. This can be explained by their shedding summer pelage to be replaced by a winter one. A hind leans against a fir tree and then licks off lumps of soft resin, which include hairs of summer pelage. The time of shedding slightly varies depending upon the feeding conditions of lands, the fatness of animals, and the climatic conditions. But a certain regularity can be observed. Old individuals finish shedding their hair practically by the time mating begins. Young ones finish it quite later. Bucks have their pelage renewed by the middle of the mating period. Hinds not yet. During the filming, we could observe bucks guarding over their harems in their winter pelage, while hinds were still light reddish, as they are in summer. With the beginning of mating, hinds temporarily abandon their offspring, forming a harem, the size of which depends upon the quantity of deer in the area. A buck follows such a harem, jealously guarding it from other bucks. As the heat of hinds begins, bucks fully display their vital capacity, having their harems. This period is accompanied by constant roar of bucks. That's why it is sometimes called the roaring period. Bucks roar practically the whole day, and their roar carries particularly well in starlit nights. Solitary bucks, having no harem, become furious and try to win over their rival's harem. Bucks often fight, sometimes with fatal outcome. There have been cases when bucks, having their horns stuck together, died of starvation or were torn by wolves. It is the self-denying behavior that must be the reason for calling this animal the noble deer in some languages. Two solitary bucks, having no harem in this period, just rush at each other, and the fight lasts till both of them are completely exhausted or one of them gains a definitive victory over the other. This buck is sniffing the Solanet soil. Its behavior suggests that it is looking for a harem. In summer and autumn, the deer gladly visits Solanetes. The chemical analysis of the Solanet soil indicates the presence of soda, sodium chloride, and sulfide. When mating begins, day migrations increase, especially with bucks having no harem. Reduced food supplies in autumn, constant search for a female mate, or a harem, add to the necessity of migration. This period is accompanied by roaring and fights resulting in injuries. This buck has an injury on the right horn. However, it can be seen that the length of its supraorbital antlers has allowed it to win many fights already. The exhausted animal decided to have a bit of rest on the Solanets, most likely hoping to meet one or several hinds here. It looks like it's going to stay here till the evening hours, when day migrations begin. The Solanets has a herbaceous vegetation, including salibloom, butterbur, and fescue grass. Bucks start to copulate at the age of 3 or 4 years, as adult stags don't allow hinds any access to them when they are younger. The heat of hinds occurs at the age of 2 or 3 years. Pregnancy lasts for 240-270 days. Hinds usually fawn in May or June, some individuals in early July. They bring into the world one, rarely two fawns. Newborn fawns have a reddish coloring. On each side of the trunk there are 6 irregular rows of white spots. They have this coloration until they are shedding in autumn. During the first 2 or 3 days of life, fawns lie and get up only to suck milk. After 1 week, they can already run well. A fawn sucks its mother's udder until the winter cold, with a break in the period of mating. The main reasons for the deer's death are predators and severe and snowy winters. The deer may suffer from foot and mouth disease, anthrax, necrobacillosis, parotyphoid, and some other diseases which may become epizootic. The period of mating is over. No bucks fights, no roaring. It is the end of October. Due to natural life circumstances, this hind is now standing alone, without the fawn she brought into the world in late spring or early summer. It is unknown when she lost it, in the period of mating or in summer. Apparently, it became the wolf's prey. This hind will have to carry the embryo again, but this time in severe winter conditions, with its low temperatures and reduced food supplies of the area. At every moment, the animal may face the sudden danger of being torn by predators, but she must survive herself and save the life of her offspring, which is due to be born in spring. The whole burden of the species' reproduction falls on the fragile nature of the hind.